Can I retrieve a message I sent via a web form? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. Last week I sent an email to my congressman via his website and never made a copy of it. Anyway, his office responded with a generic answer that referred to the subject and not the real question. I can't remember how my email was worded and I was wondering if there was any way to retrieve it, even though it was sent directly to his site. Thanks. To be clear, if you used an online form at the website, this is not email. You did not send email. Web forms are online website-specific ways of gathering data. A good example is my Ask Leo Ask a Question form. So if we take a quick look at that, if we scroll down this page, you'll see that it's a pretty typical form. It gives you things to enter, like your name, your email address, a subject. In my case, I ask you for the operating system and a question, and you hit a submit, or in my case, an Ask Leo button. It's not email, at least not from your perspective. Because what can happen is that behind the scenes, any number of different approaches to collecting this information might be employed. Yes. Email might be sent. In fact, the Ask Leo web form does send email to me. But it's not you sending the email. It's my server sending the email. Another approach is for this data that you've just entered, as soon as you hit the submit button, to get entered into a database. No email is involved at all. Another approach is to simply write the information to a file, again, on the server. No email is involved. And the information is available for whoever has the right to access it in those files that are saved, again, on the server. And of course, the cynic in me says that there's a fourth option where absolutely nothing is saved anywhere and it just made you feel good to hit the submit button, but the information is actually discarded. I hope it's not the case, but I'm afraid that it probably happens a little bit more often than you think. So, since you aren't really sending email, there is nothing for you to retrieve. You don't have access to those files. You don't have access to the database. You don't have access to whatever technique that web server happened to use to collect your data. What do you do? There are two approaches. My recommended approach is, in fact, to compose your message using a different program. Notepad is a great example. Just fire up Notepad, type in your message, and then copy-paste it into the appropriate field in that web form. That way you can also save your message as a text file somewhere on your computer. The other approach is kind of to do the opposite. Go ahead and enter your message in the web form, but then before you hit submit, do a Control-A to select the entire message, and then copy it and paste it to Notepad, or whatever other program you want to use, so that you can save the text to a file. But ultimately, those are the options. You need to do something with the text before you hit submit that actually allows it to be saved on your PC. Now, question, of course, is why web forms? Why not just send email? Well, a couple of reasons. To begin with, I do both. You can send me email, leo@askleo.com, or more ideally, what works better for me is if you use the web form. The reason the web form works is that it is somewhat more difficult to send spam. You can imagine, my email gets a lot of spam. That means that sometimes legit messages are occasionally missed. By using a web form, I control how it's delivered, how it gets to me, and spammers, while they exist, while web form spam is a thing, they're not nearly as prevalent as email spam. It's possible to include required fields. My form is a great example. I've got this option here that says operating system. That's like one piece of data that can make a huge difference to me as I answer your questions. This is something that I then require. I require a subject and your email address, and if you miss those, the form won't go in. If you use email and you leave out that information, well, that's information that I might need, but you haven't provided. The web form allows me to structure the information a little bit more so that it can be more useful to me. That's true for almost every web form on the internet. It's possible to validate some of these forms. So, for example, you might enter an email address, but if you enter something that can't be an email address, I can check. And I can say, hey, this isn't an email address. Please enter something that is. And of course, kind of a variation of the required fields is that there can be a series of questions or a series of fields that allow you to provide incrementally more information, again, to whatever the situation that web form was designed for requires. But that's the bottom line here, is that if you think you're about to use a web form and it's something you want to save for yourself, you need to save it for yourself before you hit submit. Either write it in a different program and copy it in, or write it in the web form and copy it out to that different program. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/5795. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.